Talk Shoe.
Recorded live.
Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, wake up everybody.
coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children to jump the very best you can.
Thank you. back and I pray and I pray. Well.
To see if he's still on the throne. Yeah, I didn't have my, but that's all right. I got it now. Amen. I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. Well, good morning. Praise him. This is another day that the Lord has made. He predestined. He already had this day in the making. Made, done deal, and here we are again this morning. We give all praise and honor and glory to the King. A relationship with the King, yes, is worth having, waiting on, and living for, because he can bring you back before you even get off. Hallelujah. Amen. He's the only one that can bring you back, deliver you, set you free, bring you out, keep you in. Hallelujah. Nobody but the Elohim. Praise him. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning for this day, for this opportunity, for the unctioning and propelling us to be a part of you. Hallelujah. You and us and we and you. Hallelujah. And we can live in a righteousness world. So we bless and thank, amen, the Most High Yah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I pray that all have been well with each and every one of you guys. And you can call in at 724-444-7444. Access code is 111253. Call in and be a part of the program that's blessing your life, my life, others. Hallelujah. You got to have some word this morning. Glory to God. If you don't have word, you think, amen, high blood pressure is bad. You will have any and other disease on the map. Next thing you know, cancer will try. You know, you will be tried. Not by God. Hallelujah. The Most High, he's not in the business of trying you, for he knows what's in you. He created you. Amen. Hallelujah. We're grateful this morning. I want to talk this morning about faith. Hallelujah. We hear a lot, we hear a whole lot of people talking about faith. But when it comes time to live what you've been speaking, you sometimes stumble. You kind of stumble a little bit in trying to believe that if I hold on to that
which was spoken to me, or that which I asked of Almighty for, or that which I'm believing for, whatever, hallelujah, it's going to take some faith. And here we want to recognize that the world is framed by your words, hallelujah. You know, we go back to tripped by your lip and hung by your tongue. You say, what do you mean, man? Say, well, the moment your lips start motioning and that tongue come out, hallelujah, it's like that snake. That snake will start motion. When you see him, he'll snatch back and throw his head up or just straight out just bite you. Hallelujah. Well, the word is quick. Hallelujah. The Bible said that the word of God is quick and sharp. Amen. Let's look at Hebrews 4 and 12, and let's see what he says about the words. Hebrews 4 and 12. Let's see here. Where you at? Let me get my eyes on that thing. For the word of Yah is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit and of joints and marrow, and is the discerner of the thought and intent of the heart. Hallelujah. See, the word of God, hallelujah, that's all he gave us was a word, hallelujah. We believe on our jobs, and we believe that we're going to have a party, hallelujah. We believe all these things, but what about believing the word this morning, hallelujah? The world was framed by the word of God, hallelujah. Let there be, and there was. Hallelujah. He's given us a word this morning to tell us the only way for you to acquire, to live, be healed, well, and go about doing what is right in the sight of the Father. The word. Hallelujah. Matthew, the 4th chapter, you find, amen, Yahshua, using the word of his mouth on the devil. Hallelujah. Told the devil, for it is written. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the word is power, sharp and quick. Hallelujah. We need the word this morning. So we come this morning to talk about your faith, my faith, and let's draw a line in our minds that penetrate into our heart. The only way to do battle with the devil, you have no business doing battle whatsoever with the devil. You have no business fighting the devil. Your testimony should never be nothing about what the devil done. Hallelujah. Put Satan on the run the same way that Yahshua kept him running. And the Bible says in Matthew 4, amen, and Matthew 4, and the last thing Jesus told him, he told him, he said, be gone. He told the devil, you know, he didn't have no crucifix. He didn't have no scars to show the devil or anything. Hallelujah. He had nothing to show the devil but some word. Hallelujah. And we find the devil tempting the Lord in Matthew, the 4th chapter. Now, Matthew, the 4th chapter, it says that he was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted for the devil, to be tempted by the devil. Now, who led him up. Satan was the power, and he is today, and the prince of the air. Uh-huh. So Yahshua was being led up to be tried by the prince of the air. The Bible said, and when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, afterward he was hungry. Now when the tempter came to him, he said, if. She's always, hallelujah, trying to make you distrust and fall out of your ranks with God by if you can wait, then I guess we can wait. If you don't do this, then you're going to be fine. If you don't take these medicines, you're going to go blind. If. It's always contention in this warfare, hallelujah, of life before death. You got to live this morning. You got to thrive, glory to God. You got to know that anyhow, anyhow, if he don't come on time, but he'll save me. He'll save me from you, Satan. He'll save me from you. Hallelujah. We find that Jesus, Yahshua, he had to have some faith. Hallelujah. He is the one to show you. So he coming in fleshly form. And as he came in fleshly form, he had the same desires all of us have today. But he defeated the enemy to prove to humanity that all it takes is faith in your mouth. All it takes is faith in you directing your words this morning. Hallelujah. Or you need to read and see how that he was an exterminator in the fourth chapter. Hallelujah. Of Matthew, how he kept putting the word on Satan. He didn't use anything outside of the word. There was no fight. There was no argument. There was nothing. There was nothing that was being done physically. It was the word of God. Hallelujah. And the Bible tells us this morning in the 11th chapter of Hebrews, it says, now faith is the substance. Substance means you got to have all your stuff together to make a cake. So the substance of the cake was vanilla extract, egg, and flour. Those are the substance to making a cake. But we're talking about, hallelujah, the substance that produces faith this morning. Hallelujah. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it, the elders obtain a good testimony. Hallelujah. You see, the Bible says, by faith, we understand that the world was framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are invisible, which are seen were not made of the things which are invisible. The Bible says that the things that he created, there was no invisibility to it. It wasn't laying back in limbo. It wasn't in the bank account. It wasn't in the trunk of my car. He did not produce this thing, faith, amen, out of something that was just laying around. Which means to me this morning that your faith can't be stored up in the bank. Your faith cannot be in man. Your faith cannot be in anything that was made. Hallelujah. He manifested this thing, faith, and built it and stood behind it with a guarantee that, hallelujah, if you wait upon me, you're going to have what you say. Now look with me in Mark 11:23, and let's see why it is so important for us to use our words wisely, because you're going to have what you say. I want to help you this morning because this is nothing for me. I'm living it every day, and it's a wonderful ride. It's guaranteed that my destiny, hallelujah, it is acquirable, and I will entertain that, and it'll entertain me. And it's going to be good for me because it came from the Father of life. Hallelujah. Can't no devil block you or stop you. With this type of teaching, this type of learning and hearing, faith comes by hearing, and hearing comes by the word of God. Hallelujah. We're talking about faith this morning. We're talking about how that Moses and all the prodigals, how that they overcome. That's why he said that the elders, he's referring to generations and generations ago of the elders that stood and declared that, yes, the word is well with me. Hallelujah. All I need is the word this morning. Hallelujah. Bring all the money, the lotto, hallelujah. It'll take me from God. I'll go on a journey. Sometimes he wants to keep his children, so he gives them the desires of their heart and not give them too much, because too much may cause me not to be here preaching. Hallelujah. Amen. Too much will cause you to have too many things to do. And I'm telling you the truth. I know, because I'm living like that. I don't want stuff. But you know, down through life, you acquire stuff. Hallelujah. If you, amen, in the field of construction, whatever you're in, you're going to have some stuff like that. Amen. And that stuff can keep you from participating and going where you should be at, because you got to look over your stuff. And it's just time to give it all to the Father, because it's nothing we can do in our own strength this morning but burn ourselves out and wear ourselves down trying to manage this life. This life wasn't meant to be managed. Hallelujah. It was meant for you to be managed by him and be his gardener and take care of the earth. Instead, we're trying to take care of our stuff and the people we love. Go to school, get a good education, go to college so you can get a good job, so you can raise a good family. And that's about the style of the American lifestyle. Everybody wants this lifestyle. They're at borders right now trying to come into America so that they can have the American dream, hallelujah, the land of the free. And if we don't do something, amen, in faith and begin to speak over this land, hallelujah, the corruption. The Bible says pray for those that are in leadership. Most of us, we don't even want to see him in leadership. Let's long pray for him. Pray for your president. Hallelujah. No matter whether you like it or not, the Father allowed him to be there, like he made a mistake or something. Come on now. Be careful what you say with words this morning. Hallelujah. We see here in the book of Mark 11 that, hallelujah, we'll go up here to Mark 11:18. And scribes and the chief priests heard it and sought how they might destroy him, for they feared him. You're going to be feared because of your faith lifestyle. Because they feared him, because all the people were astonished at his teaching. When you teach like this, people's going to hate you. They're going to run from you because you're going to prophesy to them, and they don't want you to come. They don't want to see you because they know that you know, because he has given you insight to know. Lord, let me see if this yard man cutting his grass. Last time he blew all that dirt all over my car. Have no regard for your nice car sitting on your driveway. Y'all hold that thought. Hallelujah. He's faithful this morning. When I went outside, he had his bag laying there, I guess, to show me. He must know I was coming. He had his bag, his grass catcher bag laying there. And I looked, and I didn't see no grass all over my car. I said, Father, I thank you. That I was thinking. I never did talk to the man, but I said, oh, when I see him again, I'm going to ask him, do you have any respect for other people's property? You blew your grass all over my car, in my car, and I don't think you meant to do that. I don't think he meant to do it. But the Holy Spirit spoke to him. That's faith. Having a God kind of faith this morning, hallelujah, can talk to people's. You know, all we need is favor today. If we can have favor with one person, that one person may know the king and may present you before the king. Hallelujah. You know what happened to Daniel and Nebuchadnezzar and all that stuff. You know what happened to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Got them before the king so the king can bleed. All of those kings, except for Pilate. Pilate told Paul, he said, you almost persuaded me to be a Christian. Almost. Almost is not good enough this morning, saints. We need to walk in the Word of God. We need to know where the Word of God is written at. Hallelujah. We need to write them on the tables of our heart. We need to be able, amen, to go through the Word of God and break it down. Hallelujah. We were talking about the scribes and Pharisees over in the book of Mark 11. And we're talking about, amen, the tongue, how that we get tripped up, amen, in our words. And this is going to validate that your faith-filled words will put you over or put you under. So we're talking from the book of Hebrews, the 11th chapter. It talks about now is faith and how that the elders obtain a good report. And now we've gotten down to how do faith stick. You can't stick it with glue, amen. You can't net it. Amen. It's something that's going to have to be produced out of your mouth. So it says that scribes over in Mark 11 and 18, how that the scribes and the Pharisees, how that they hated the truth, they hated the word, hallelujah. So the 20th verse, he said, now in the morning as they passed by, saw a fig tree dried up from its roots, and Peter remembered, said to him, Rabbi, look, the fig tree you cursed has withered away. Now that's back down further, back up above, how that the fig tree, Yahshua and his boys and his gang was hungry. You know, he had a gang of 12 disciples, amen. They were gangsters. They weren't just normal people. People hated them too. Hated Matthew because he was a tax collector. Sure hated Paul because he was a murderer. Peter thought to be unstable. So all these boys were with Jesus, amen, walking with the king, and they were like gangsters. But he took those gangsters, amen, and he put that word in them. He showed them how to live and walk in faith. So the writer says, Jesus, amen, had spoken to this tree because it didn't have no fruit on it. And it says, so Jesus, in the 22nd verse of Mark 11, Mark 11:22. So Jesus answered and said to them, have faith in God, for assuredly I say to you, whoever say to this mountain, say, we're talking about the tongue. See, any mountain, any situation in your life, hallelujah, that's bigger than you and you can't work it out, it's a mountain. And Jesus gave an illustration on how to deal with mountains, crisis. See, above that, they wanted to kill him, you see. So he was stopping them from talking about how that they want to kill him by telling them, have faith in God. I'm not walking alone. You don't see my protection. I hope you got some protection. That's the first thing the world say is you got your protection. If he don't protect you, one protection won't stop seven guys riding by shooting you. Even if you got bodyguards, if you're going to die, you can die in your sleep. So what protection? It's more dangerous trying to sleep at night because you might not wake up than it is riding down Highway 6, amen, where you can get hit, ran over, killed, or road raced to death. Just for you to sleep in the morning and get up, it was more dangerous then because the enemy was hampering and messing with your life in your sleep. Hallelujah. Have faith in God, for surely I say to you, whoever speaks to the mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart. You got to get this doubting out your heart this morning. You got to realize that faith is just the substance. This word I'm talking about this morning, if you can just believe on the word, if you just think on the word and let the word become real to you, that I'm going to hold on to my confidence, which has great reward of recompense, for my needs will be met according to this word. You got to speak to your mind. You can't be tripped by your lip and, amen, and hung by your tongue by saying, you know, I'm tired of going through and I've been holding on and stuff, you know, in the church, and don't seem like they're going to ever let me preach. Don't seem like they're going to ever let me usher. Don't seem like they're going to ever let me sing my song. But you got to hold on, because when that time comes, see, he trying to use somebody, and you being the type of tool that, you know, you're a wrench, you're any size, you know, you're 9, 16, 5, 8, 13, 16, 3 quarter, a quarter inch. You fit all. And he wants to use you this morning. He wants to use you as a tool, amen, of encouragement, a tool of enlightenment, a tool, amen, to show the disciples and the world that the same tempter that was out to tempt the greatest of all faith level is still out to tempt you and try and trick you and get you caught up in conversations, hallelujah, that ain't even none of your business. 1 Thessalonians 4:11 said, mind your own business. Hallelujah. If I spend more time minding my own business and passing up other people's business, I think I might can keep my faith walking, keep talking about faith. Too many things come to take us away from the will of God. Hallelujah. So he says here, if you would speak to your mountain this morning, tell it to be removed and be cast into the sea. We don't use words like Matthew 18:18 say you got to bind it. And if you bind it, he will bind it. We don't bind it, you understand me? We just pray. He's already given you the tool to overcome your situation, but you got the Matthew 18:18 You got to bind that thing up this morning. Hallelujah. You got to bind it up, and when you bind it on earth, he said he's going to bind it in heaven. And then when you loose that thing, see, he said you got to bind and loose. So therefore, you got to tell it, amen, be gone. Hallelujah. You got to do what Yahshua did in Matthew, the 4th chapter, when the enemy come the last time and said, if you bow down and worship me, Satan want to be worshipped today. Hallelujah. He didn't want you to bow down, live in sin, so he can win and you lose. If you bow down. But the exterminator, Yahshua, he told him, for it is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God, even your God. Be gone. And the devil leaveth him, and the angels came and ministered to our wonderful Prince of Peace. He wants to minister to you this morning. He wants to show you that this thing is acquirable, it's attainable, you can have what you say. You need to stop saying things that does not mean nothing. It's so easy to get caught up in trying to straighten a situation out. I can't straighten out my life. I war with preaching all the time. I warred last night about how I'm going to bring the word. That's why the music was all distorted, you know, trying to discourage me so I don't do what I'm set to do. This is my life. This is what I do. This is what he gave me to do. He has taken away my desires because I told him, if anything that's going to glorify me or anybody else, and you get not the glory, remove it from me, whether it be something that I, amen. You know, it could be anything. I don't care what it is today, because I cannot go any further with doubting. Hallelujah. I know too much about him. He showed me too many things. Amen. I know, you know, the fall I fell on my head, I should have been dead. But if he let me live, and I didn't bleed, amen, but I believed that faith, I didn't need to go to the hospital. Mine kept saying, you might have some fluid on your head. You better go to the hospital. And I thought, fluid on the head, if that's all I got from falling, amen, on my head, then I can live with it. If it didn't kill me, the devil trying to trick me. If you got fluid on your brain, it could kill you. If I got anything on my brain this morning that could kill me, hallelujah, it should have been killed, man. I'm alive and I'm well this morning. Hallelujah. I know about how he felt this morning when he being tempted of the devil. That's why I'm telling you this morning, saints, that, hallelujah, you were created for this world. And this world was created for you. But the chaos, hallelujah, that the same destroyer, the same tempter that came to Yahuwah, amen, in Mark 11 chapter, and said, if you need to beware today that Satan is on the prowl. The Bible says that when Satan, amen, knew that he could not overthrow the kingdom of the Most High God, he said, I will go and I will attack the human race. And he started with Eve. You know how the story went. Amen. I don't need to even bring you back, amen, to Eve and how that Eve and Adam, how that, amen, they were gardeners and they were producers and they were productive and they lived in faith and they lived by faith. Hallelujah. And then the battle began. Hallelujah. And that's what brought about Yahshua, is because the creation that the Father had said, let there be. And I'm trying to show you and tell you this morning, my friend, that your let there be going to have to be stored up in faith, because without faith, it is impossible to believe God. You got to have faith. I hate to close out on such a strong, powerful message. Amen. But how do you go about creating your world this morning? Hallelujah. You see, my friend, the author of this book that I'm talking about, the book of Hebrews, it states that through faith we understand that the works were framed by the word of God. Hallelujah. He further states that God, that the great I am, did not make the world out of things that are seen. He then describes that faith, amen, the faith that we're talking about this morning. He described that the faith we must have to accept this concept. That faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. When you examine this concept this morning, you're coming up with a thrilling idea. You find the Creator, the Almighty, hallelujah, capable of calling something into being out of nothing. At least nothing visible to us. We can't see it this morning. But as a result, your behalf isn't built on a provable fact this morning. You don't need to prove nothing. You can in yourself have the evidence of things not seen. They're already in you this morning. But that is as far as it goes. If someone you know, hallelujah, is to have this evidence, it must be as a result of their faith. My faith cannot bring about these things in your life today. If they don't have the faith, they don't have the evidence. Hallelujah. You cannot say, see, the evidence of faith will cause you to understand that you don't need to go to the doctor, amen, to get your head checked, because some of us need to be dropped on our head. Hallelujah. They don't have the evidence this morning. I'm coming to a close. I don't know why God saw fit to create this world, amen, in such a fashion, amen. He could, amen. He sure have done a great job. Hallelujah. Some other way which, amen, I also wouldn't have understood. I'm not sure understanding is what creation of life is all about. However, I'm glad that he chose the way he did to create the world. All I have to do then is try to create my own world. See, we've been trying to create and recreate the world around us. Been trying to change people's, amen, and change places. Some people live all over the world. They go here, they go there, they go there, they go there, they go to this job, amen. Why? Because they have not figured out how to create their own world. Hallelujah. You need to make a few personal observations this morning. Hallelujah. First of all, I don't have to wait around most of my life gathering material, amen, for this project. I can call forth from the center of myself this morning those things not seen and get started. You see, we've been gathering material to build our world, and he said, you have not because you ask not, and when you ask amiss that you may consume it upon your lust. You need to create your world inside of this world is passing away, the Bible said, in the lust of the eye and the pride of the, he said, the world is, you need to create your own world this morning. I have my own world today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I did it my own self through faith, through the substance of things hoped for. No, I didn't see it, but I stood on the promises of the word. Hallelujah. I said, Lord, if it be for me, let me have it this way. And then as I was trying to get it my way, that my faith arena had me, the tempter was coming all the time. Could have missed it. Could have lost my life. Anything can happen if you embrace faith and then your words are not faith-filled words to keep you standing. You're not going to stand. You're going to sink. All the stuff we're trying to do today. I need this word more than anything. You may look and say, you know, apostle is well versed in the word and apostle is that. Yeah, you say anything you want to say, whether good, bad, or evil. I don't care. But I know that this is not something I have a desire to do this thing, but I don't want to do it. But it's good for me. So the enemy wants to keep you from this type of teaching and make you not like the teacher. You don't have the word. Matthew 22:29, it says you do hell for not knowing scripture, neither the power of God. It's nothing I said wrong. It's the word of God that you don't measure up to. You're not trying to measure up to because you don't really walk by faith. You walk by sight. You walk by your money. You walk by the things you see and the things you possess. You need to drop it like it's hot because you're not going anywhere because your resources are run out. You've been grabbing material to try and make your own world, and your own world is not the world he wants you to live in this morning. I'm just going to sit here, and I'm going to call it forth this morning. Hallelujah. I'm going to call it from the center of my being. Hallelujah. Those things not seen, and I'm going to, amen, I'm going to do what the word says. Have you ever wondered why creative ideas come from? Have you ever wondered where they come from and why they come? Hallelujah. They often just show up seemingly from somewhere. They certainly are not the product of anything seen. Because if you saw it, or if it was already yours, or you already was going to get it, you can't say faith got it because you might have bought it and called it faith. Hallelujah. God specialized this morning in bringing things down that you can't reach up to. I'm glad about it this morning, family and friend. I should just sit here and just preach all day because you know why? Whatever I need, it's already wrapped up in me. So I'm going to do what I've been doing, and I'm going to speak to it, amen, and say, now bring it to pass. I already prayed about it and told the Father, I don't know what to do today. So many things nabbing at my heart. Appointments I made through another friend of mine, and I just got to be in faith, so I have to go and tell the other person that no can do, because one participator didn't, I ain't going to say because he might jump up and do anything,
But his word said, can't make it.
Nah. I'm not going to take this call. So we'll let it just go. I want you to understand this morning that you got to think different. You got to be thinking this morning that I can possess this thing. I'm going to wait. I'm going to take my time, and I'm going to wait to hear from the creator of this world so that my world won't be so clouded, so confused, and so tiring. This world will make you tired. Just to talk with people in the world will make you tired. Most of my tiredness comes from dealing with people. But I guess that's what I was set forth to do. We need to be about the Father's business today. And we need to speak these faith-filled words so that we can create our own world, so we can live in it, but yet still be a person that's in the world, but I have the world of truth living inside of me. You can't live in this world and then not be a participator of the world by going out and buying any and everything you see. You know, sometimes something that we own, we don't need it in our life because those things own us. And we don't need to be owned by anything. We were bought with the price. The price was paid, and we want to live true to the Father. Amen. We've this morning brought a wonderful message. I believe that it was from the throne of the Most High. I give him the glory and all of the honor. Father, I thank you this morning for your call. It was a holy call. And you called me, Father, right here to, amen, to be a part of this program. Keep calling me, Father, for I need it. And that's a refreshing. It's a breath of fresh air this morning to my mind, body, and soul. Takes away all the things that I need to do, for my steps have been ordered in you. I thank you this morning. And likewise, for those that are listening, those that, amen, will catch the recording, I pray over your life that that thing that you're waiting on, it could be healing. It could be a financial miracle. It could be a breakthrough. It could be your loved ones. It could be whatever. Amen. I want you to stop speaking. Hallelujah. Teach them to stop speaking what they see, and teach them to speak what they want and not what they don't, Father. And I give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor right now in the Most High, Yah. Selah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.